Hey guys, today I've got something a little different for you, a new free open source command line tool we're calling git-flow-next. If you're already familiar with the popular git-flow tool, you'll feel right at home. Our tool was built on top of the original git-flow and git-flow-avh, which is why we went with a similar name. So you might be asking, what's new? If you've seen our latest Tower for Mac release, Tower 14, this is basically the command line version of the same idea. You can configure base and topic branches, define your preferred upstream and downstream merge strategies, and set additional functionalities, such as creating tags when merging. git-flow-next is also great for keeping branches up to date and tackling merge conflicts. It's also 100% compatible with the original git-flow, so your existing repos will just work. We wrote git-flow-next in Go, and the Tower team will be actively maintaining it. Since it's open source, feel free to jump on GitHub and contribute. Alright, let's dive into a quick tour. First, we'll use the standard git-flow model, and then we'll check out the fully custom setup. To get started, we recommend using Homebrew. Alternatively, you can head over to the releases page on our GitHub account. The documentation has all the info you'll need if you choose that option. You can then confirm git-flow-next has been installed by typing which git-flow. Let's begin with the classic git-flow approach. To kick things off, just type git-flow init. This will allow you to set up git-flow interactively. You can use this opportunity to rename any branches as you see fit. Otherwise, just keep pressing enter. If you then type git-flow overview, you'll see that git-flow is now properly configured. You can start working on a new feature by typing git-flow feature start, followed by the name of your feature branch. When you're finished with your work, type git-flow feature finish and the branch name to merge your changes into the valid branch. Once successfully merged, your local branch will be automatically deleted. By the way, git-flow and git-flow-next are fully compatible with Tower 14 for Mac. You'll just need to select it by clicking the workflow button and choosing the right option. Despite the name, git-flow-next isn't just for git-flow. You can use presets for two other popular options, GitHub Flow and GitLab Flow. GitHub Flow uses main as the base branch and establishes one topic branch for feature creation. GitLab Flow will use three main branches, main, staging, and production, and establish two topic branches, feature and hotfix. You can also use git-flow init with the custom option for an interactive configuration. In this simple example, we'll be using main as our trunk branch and set up two topic branches, feature and post, so that we can add blog posts to this project. As you can see here, we are also indicating that the downstream merge strategy should be set to rebase for our post topic branch. If you need more information than what the overview command provides, you can always access the config file located inside the .git folder for additional details. And of course, if you'd like to edit any configured branch, you can use the git-flow config edit command. In this example, we're adding the possibility to create tags on finish. For all the info, please check the git-flow-next documentation, which includes all available commands and examples. Tower 14 lets you know when a branch needs to be updated if its parent branch has received changes. In here, you can see the main branch has a new commit. You can easily integrate it into your feature branch, as you can see. We thought it would be a good idea to bring that to git-flow-next as well. So, you can simply type git-flow-update to integrate those changes into your feature branch. It's smart to use this command often to keep your branches in sync and avoid a pile of merge conflicts later. And speaking of merge conflicts, Tower 14 also lets you know if you'll run into them when updating a branch. We also added this feature to git-flow-next, so you'll see a clear message about the conflicts when attempting to update the branch. We think git-flow-next is going to be a fantastic tool for developers who want a modern, flexible approach to their Git workflows. We hope you enjoy it. Give it a shot.